Hey guys, Momona Tamada here. Before Laura Jean Covey, Ellie Chu, and Devi Vishwakumar, there was one Asian female character who inspired Asian Americans everywhere. Claudia Kishi from The Babysitter's Club. In the 80s and 90s, there wasn't much Asian representation in movies, books, or TV shows. Anytime they did appear, they were presented as stereotypical characters or one-dimensional sidekicks. But in 1986, Anna Martin's The Babysitter's Club book series introduced the world to Japanese-American Claudia Kishi, vice president, resident artist, and arguably the coolest member of The Babysitter's Club. For many Asian American women, this marked the first times they saw themselves in popular media. What made Claudia Kishi so groundbreaking was how unapologetic she was about being herself and how she defied stereotypical portrayals of Asian characters. She wasn't quiet, nerdy, and shy. She was artistic, creative, popular, and got terrible grades in school. Except for an art class, of course. Claudia marched to the beat of her own drum. She hid junk food and hollowed out books, went to school dances with boys, and famously drew herself as a butterfly for her first grade self-portrait assignment, which her teacher was not happy about. Then there was her style. Claudia used fashion as a form of self-expression, which ultimately turned her into a style icon. Her outfits consisted of bold colors, clashing prints, and of course, lots and lots of jewelry. She could mix and match anything and turn them into the coolest outfits. Though others in Stony Brook thought her style was outrageous, Claudia was confident in what she wore and owned it. She was a girl everyone, not just Asian American girls, wanted to be. Asian American women also saw their families in Claudia's family. She had strict parents who she constantly felt like she was disappointing, and an older, book-smart sister Janine who she'd struggled to get along with and live up to. Then there was her beloved live-in grandmother Mimi, who immigrated from Japan. Back then, it was rare to see a relationship between an Asian American grandparent and grandchild, and Mimi and Claudia's relationship was extra special. Mimi understood Claudia and embraced her artsy, free-spirited side, and encouraged Claudia to not hide who she was from the world. For many Asian American families who also lived in multi-generation homes, seeing this relationship was precious. Claudia normalized the Asian American experience and made Asian Americans finally feel accurately represented. The later books of the series even tackle the racism Claudia endures, specifically when a woman named Mrs. Lowell refuses to let her and her black friend Jessie babysit her children. But Claudia's character wasn't all about her race. It went beyond that. She was a nuanced young girl who helped redefine and reimagine what young Asian American girls in pop culture could look like and could be. She was a role model for aspiring creators, many of whom are now creating groundbreaking works and stories of their own featuring Asian American female leads. Claudia continues to be an important marker of Asian representation in mainstream media, and she still is the coolest girl in the Babysitter's Club, in my opinion. I'm hoping to see more diversity and inclusivity in pop culture and mainstream media. I really hope we get to a point where everybody is able to really see themselves accurately represented on screen. Thanks for watching!